Hello everyone, today we are going to see the continuation of the yesterday problem, like serial and the parallel connection circuits. So you have to find the I1, I2 and I in the circuit shown. This is your given circuit. You have to find out what is I and what is I1 and what is I2. To find out what is I and I1 and I2, you have to find out the equivalent resistance for this network first. First you have to take 6 ohm and 3 ohm which is connected in parallel. So 6 ohm and 3 ohm both are connected in parallel. So equivalent resistance of this parallel network is 2 ohm. Now this 2 ohm and 8 ohm both are connected in parallel, series. So just series connection. So you have got 10 ohm as the answer. So 10 ohm is just equivalent resistance of this entire network. Now just I is equal to V by R equivalent. So V is 10 volt, R equivalent is 10 volt. So if you simplify that, then you are getting I equal to 1 ampere. So your total current which is delivered by this 10 volt battery is, I forget to mention the voltage here, which is 10 volt battery. So this 10 volt battery is delivering 1 ampere current, which we have found out now, which is 1 ampere current. It is delivering 1 ampere current. Now you have to find out what is I1 and what is I2 by using current divider rule, because total current I is flowing and which is diverting into I1 and I2, where this R1 and R2 are the parallel resistance. So just substitute the values in the current divider rule. So I1 equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So R2 is 3. So 3 into 3 plus 6, you are getting 1 by 3 ampere. Similarly, I2. It is 6 I into 6 divided by 6 plus 3. I is 1 ampere. So if you simplify, then you are getting I1 and I2. So I1 is 1 by 3 ampere. So just 1 divided by 3 ampere. Similarly, I2, 2 by 3 ampere. So you have find out what is I1, what is I2 and what is I. This is your answer for this network. So next problem, same like that, here find the current through all the branches. You have to find out the current through all the branches. So how many branches are here, you have to find out. This is your source battery which is delivering the current. Here it is I which is going here and meeting this node. This node having two more branches. This is another branch, this is another branch. Again this current is flowing and it is meeting this node, and again it is diverting, separating into two branches. So you have to find out totally I, which is flowing through four branch current, you have to find out. To find out the total current, first you have to find out the equivalent resistance. So first you just take this 4 ohm and a 5 ohm which is connected in series. So 9 ohm is the equivalent resistance of this series circuit. Then this 9 ohm is connected parallel with this 18 ohm. Okay. So this 9 ohm is connected parallel with this 18 ohm. So 18 ohm parallel to 9 ohm. So you have got 6 ohm. Again this 6 ohm is connected series with this. So both are added because both are in series. Next, again this 6 volt, this 6 volt is connected not only 6 volt, up to 6 volt is connected parallel with this 4 ohm. Okay, then you have got the equivalent resistance as 3 ohm. Again this 3 ohm resistor is connected in series with this 2 ohm resistor. So you have got 5 ohm as the equivalent resistor, which is connected in series with this source voltage. Then you have to find out what is I equal to 50/5. Then you have got 10 ampere is your total current. Now you have to again find what is the branch currents in all the branches. Again you have to go in reverse. So this 10 ampere is the total current which is flowing in this network. This is your actual network, 2 ohm which is connected to 4 ohm resistor and 6 ohm resistor. Okay, look at this. This 5 ohm is a combination of 3 ohm and 2 ohm which is in series. Again this 3 ohm is combination of 12 ohm and 4 ohm. That's what I have written here. So this 2 ohm which is having a parallel connection of 4 ohm and 12 ohm. No need to write this 12 ohm resistor in depth, because by using this current divider rule you are going to find out what is I1 and I2. This I2 is the total current which is flowing here. I1 is the current which is flowing through 4 ohm resistor here. So this I1 current you just take as it is. Instead of this total network, you take 12 ohm as the equivalent resistance of this entire network, so that you can find what is the I2 current here. So just apply the current divider rule. So I1 equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. If you apply, then you are getting 7.5 ampere as your I1 current. So 7.5 ampere. Similarly, if you apply for the I2, you are getting 2.5 ampere. Sum of these two currents equal to 10 ampere, that is your total current. Now you have find out what is I1 which is flowing through 4 ohm resistor. Again this 12 ohm resistor is a combination of few more resistor. Just you elaborate it. Now this 12 ohm resistor is the equivalent resistance of this 18 ohm and a 9 ohm resistor. Again this 9 ohm is a single branch, still it is a combination of 4 ohm and 5 ohm resistor. Anyhow, the current flowing through this branch is, this single branch is same, even through 4 ohm and 5 ohm both are same, the current is, that is I4. Now again what you have to take, your I2 is 2.5 ampere. So the current means the total current which is flowing through this node is 2.5, which is the incoming current. So this is your node where this 2.5 ampere current is flowing and which is separating into I3 and I4. Okay, just dividing to through 18 ohm and 9 ohm. Now you have to apply again the current divider rule where you have to take the total current as 2.5 ampere. Now again you have to apply this one, you have to take as R1, this one you have to take as R2. Just apply it I3 equal to total current is 2.5 ampere into opposite resistance 9 divided by total resistance 18 plus 9, which is equal to 0.8, means this is your I3 current, you have got it. Similarly, you apply for the I4 also. I4 is 1.667 ampere. So you have find out what is I1, what is I2 and what is I3 and what is I4, and you have find out this is I is equal to 10 ampere. So you have find out all the branch currents. So your problem is over. So I have given you one exercise problem to find out the current through all the branches in the circuit shown, and I have given the answer also. So you should find what is the total current. Here it is I. Similarly, here it is I1, this is I2, this is I3 through three branches, and here it is I4, it is I5. So, we have to find out all the branch current, and I have given the answer. If you have any doubt in this problem, you can do comment. If you want me to solve this problem, you do comment. If anybody want to solve, I will solve it in the next video. Thank you. We will meet in next video.